more earthquakes hit different parts of the Philippines. A magnitude 4.4 earthquake hits Bataan and other parts of Metro Manila early morning Wednesday, while a magnitude 4.7 hits Davao Oriental. These earthquakes come after the 6.1 magnitude earthquake in Luzon on Monday and the 6.5 magnitude in Visayas on Tuesday. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, or NDRRMC, says there were 16 dead, 81 injured, and 14 missing from the Luzon quake as of Tuesday. Severely damaged structures such as heritage churches in Pampanga remain closed. But the Clark International Airport, which was damaged Monday, resumes operations Wednesday afternoon. Follow Rappler.com for updates. After receiving threats from President Rodrigo Duterte, Canada vows to work with the Philippines on the garbage issue dating back 2013. This comes after Duterte on Tuesday warned to send back the garbage Canada illegally shipped to the Philippines.
We'll declare war against them. Kaya man natin yan sila. Isa uli ko talaga. Tingnan mo. Ikarga mo yan doon sa barko. Load it the containers to a ship. And advise Canada, I will advise Canada that your garbage is on the way. Prepare a grand reception. Eat it if you want to. Yung iba mga limang truck, buhos mo dyan sa Canadian Embassy.
In a statement, the Canadian Embassy says, quote, Canada is strongly committed to collaborating with the government of the Philippines to resolve this issue and is aware of the court decision ordering the importer to ship the material back to Canada. Canada explains in 2016, it amended its regulations around hazardous waste shipments to prevent such events from happening again. A new survey shows net public satisfaction in Vice President Lenny Robredo's performance jumps by 15 points in March. The latest Social Weather Stations, or SWS, survey held from March 28 to 31 says 63% of Filipinos are satisfied with Robredo's performance, while 21% are dissatisfied. This shows for a good plus 42 net satisfaction rating, the second highest net satisfaction rating of the Vice President after her plus 49 rating in September 2016. U.S. Federal Trade Commission, or FTC, probes Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg for the platform's mishandling of private data. The Washington Post reports discussions on holding Zuckerberg accountable come as Facebook and the FTC are in talks to settle an ongoing investigation. Federal regulators do not often go after executives for a company's missteps, but they might soon make an exception for Zuckerberg. Avengers Endgame opens Wednesday in Philippine cinemas. Some fans wake up to catch the screenings that start as early as 6 in the morning. Some cinemas will be operating 24 hours to accommodate the demand. Avengers Endgame is the final installment of a wildly ambitious 22-film arc featuring the beloved superheroes of the Marvel Universe, many of them the creations of late comic book legend Stan Lee.